Okay, I want to go over the two basic methods for determining the port durations. The first method, which is the one I prefer, is measuring from the top of the cylinder to the top edge of the ports. When it comes to the intake port, strangely enough, you're measuring not the top of the port, but to the bottom of the port. Because of the pistons rising, when that skirt crosses the intake bottom is when it opens. The other method is using the degree wheel. Right here, I list the reasons I don't particularly like doing the degree wheel. For one, you have to have a really secure connection on your crank. Two, you've got to have make a connection for a wire that comes out here to be your pointer. And how pointy it is important, because as you see this little distance right here, that's 10 degrees. So that pointer has to be very fine tip. But even so, you know, when you're looking at fractions of a degree, you're not going to be accurate. But that's okay. It don't matter. But getting back to the first method, you start off by finding out what the deck is. And the deck is when the piston's at TDC, how far below the top of the cylinder the edge of the piston is. Okay? And that will be a positive number as long as that piston is below the top of the cylinder. If it's above it, it becomes a negative number. So let's look at the website. Right here's the address of an online port duration calculator. It asks for the stroke, the conrod length, which if you don't know this, just put in twice what the stroke is. The piston crown to top of barrel at TDC. That's the deck. From the top edge of the piston to the top of the cylinder. That's the deck. The height over the port. That means from the top of the port to the top of the cylinder. And you click calculate, and it will show you right here what the exhaust duration is. And the same thing goes for the transfer, exactly the same. If you have a piston port engine, now you get into the input, you get into the intake duration. On an ID, these last two are different. This is the height of the piston from the top edge to the bottom edge. And this right here is the from the top of the cylinder to the bottom of the port, which would be from right here to right here. If this was the intake port, okay. And that is it. All you need is a good device for measuring, which is right here, the digital caliper. You can use a non-digital also. It's just a little bit less accurate. And what I do is I place, there's different ways to do it, but you know, working on a small cylinder, I can't stick any of this inside the cylinder. The bottom edge of the shaft right here is what I put on the top of the cylinder. And then I extend that little rectangular piece all the way down to the port edge. And if you got good eyes, you can tell when those two edges match. Or you can put a screwdriver in here, and when that touches the screwdriver, that's it. Either way. And that's it. That's That's my preferred method because it's simpler and it's less costly. And to me, it's a little bit more accurate. But like I said, I'm not going to nitpick about this because, if you're within a degree, pretty much you're going to be in the ballpark anyway. Let's say you want a 180 degree exhaust and a 120 degree transfer. Well, if you make that 181 and you make it 119, it really don't matter. The engine is not going to make a big deal out of 1 degree, okay? So you can use either method, I don't care. This method to me is a pain in the ass. I don't like it. But if you like to do it that way, maybe you'll feel like you've accomplished something. That's fine. Go for it. So you need to have a degree wheel. You've got to have a piston stop. And the idea with the piston stop is not to put it right here so that it touches at TDC because there's a few degrees at which it'll be right at the very top. So you need to have this shaft go down far enough so it will stop the piston about 20 degrees before TDC, 20 to 30, something like that. The more, the better. So you do that and you rotate this and it hits, the piston hits, and then you take note of the degrees. Then you go in the other direction until the piston hits and you take note of the degrees. And it's the dead center between those 2 degree readings where TDC is, okay? So then you can put it at TDC and then move the crank until the piston uncovers or will starts to uncover the port. This, what some people do use a really fine feeler gauge and they put it in there for the piston to have something to butt up against. But it's a little bit inaccurate because it depends upon the gauge, the width of the feeler gauge, the distance between the piston and the cylinder, so the clearance. And the angle of the port. You can do it that way. It's just, to me, it's just a little bit too southern. Okay, this is another way. I've heard this tool described. I think people just make them themselves. Maybe they make it out of a filler gauge, I'm not sure. But they put a little crook in it so that when the piston is at exactly even with that port edge, it'll be touching the tool. This should be sold because I think most people wind up using the I think the degree wheel method is more popular. I don't know why. I really don't know why. Maybe it's easier, but what do people do? Are they looking down the cylinder and trying to see when that piston uncovers the port? That's highly inaccurate. But you can get close. Okay. I'm not going to make fun of it. It's close enough. I don't care. But the thing is, right now, my cylinder is 48 cubic centimeters. It's a little engine. With little engines, you have to be more accurate. So that's just one parting thought. The tools needed, the degree wheel and the piston stop is about $34, and the digital caliper is 11. There's a few cheaper and a lot that are more expensive than that. So the only thing, that's step number one, knowing what your port durations are. Then what do you want them to be at? Okay. You really have to have a porting calculator to do that. This chart right here was made for the motorized bicycle engines, knowing what the exhaust port size is, knowing what the transfer port size is, because when you're dealing with porting for peak power RPM and you're dealing with the blowdown time, which is the time between opening the exhaust and opening the transfers, it just as much depends upon port size as it does the timing. Okay, so when people talk numbers without knowing that, to me they're just pissing in the wind. I don't even listen to them. You know, you have to have a porting calculator to get it right. It's nice to know where your port durations are, because from there you can decide on how you want them to be. And the webpage for the porting calculator that I created is right here. And it describes the details and how to get the port map, how to get detailed measurements on the exhaust port, how to measure the transfers. If you're gonna do something, do it right. Why are you gonna go buy port durations that were created 30 years ago for engines that were completely different? Why would you do that? So, and it's not expensive. It's like $10. Yeah, it's $10. I've got other calculators too. Squish velocity, boost bottle, fuel oil ratio, which tells you what ratio to use for the different oils according to RPM and type cylinder cooling. Carburetor calculator for knowing what size carburetor to use depending upon the cranking PSI. It's not as simple as just one little simple formula. It's a little bit more complex than that. What else? Jetting calculator, fantastic program. Fantastic. Crank balance, there's nothing else on the market like this. Oh, there's others, like for $300. I don't think they've gone to the pains that I went through to get this right. Expansion chamber calculator, based on a return wave simulator, which, from what I've seen the other pipe calculation programs, they have non-existent or fake return wave simulators. So that's it, my friend. Thank you for watching. Take care.